I believe, how many have enjoyed this camp? I think who has not enjoyed this camp? Okay, good.
Right.
I believe that everything that has happened,
я верю, на все, що себе сіло,
is geared toward today.
Є заволоданас.
I think God is wanting to take you to a level you have never been before.
Мислим, да Бог жали да вас обведе на ниво на кој никад не сте били.
I asked my grandfather once.
Питав сам мој дедо едно.
I was thinking of selling my business.
Каде сам мислев да продам свој бизнис.
Going to preach.
И да почнам да проповедам.
And I told him, I said, I think this is what I'm supposed to do.
И рекол сам, мислим да ово тоа што треба да го радим.
But I don't know if it's what I want to do.
Али не знам дали е тоа тоа што желим.
And my grandfather told me,
он е рекол,
it's fine to do what you want to do.
Уредно е радити тоа што желиш.
Until it's time,
док не е време,
to do what you were called to do.
Да радиш за што си позван да радиш.
And some of you up to this moment,
и некои од вас до овој момент,
have just been kind of going through the motions.
Сте пролазели само кроз емоции.
And that may have been okay then.
И тоа можеби било уредно до сад.
But it's not okay now.
Ајде yeah. Се не okay.
Because now God's called.
Јас сада Бог зове.
God's dealt with you here this week.
Бог ќе ради со вас овде.
You cannot leave here.
Не можете отići.
And go back to where you
were. Вратити се настаде.
You cannot go back to the old ways.
Не можете се вратити стари путевима.
You have to leave here.
Морате отići.
And never go back to who you used to be. It's time. Jeremiah chapter 33, verse
3. Jeremija 33, glava 3 stih. Pozovi me i ja ću ti se odazvati i obznaniti ti velike stvari i neistražive stvari o kojima ništa ne znaš.
I want us to pray that God will speak to us today.
Želim da pomolimo da Bog govori u naše srce danas.
God, I ask that you would help the way to serve you, Lord. God, you're so good to us. We thank you for everything you've done. We thank you for every word you've given us. We thank you for letting us feel your presence. But God, we're ready for something miraculous to happen in this place today. Lord, I ask that you would speak to each and every one of these young people. God, that you would tear down every stronghold, every wall, God, everything of opposition. I ask that you would move to this place in a mighty way. And God, that you would take us to a level we've never been before. That God, you would put a burden inside each and every one of these young people. A desire to know you as they've never known you before. A desire, God, that would lead them to a life that they've never lived before. To do things for you and for your kingdom, God, that have never been done before. I ask that you would anoint them, Lord, that you would pour your spirit out upon them today, Jesus. And we thank you for it, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. And in Jesus' name, amen. The scripture says, call on me.
Yes. Does it say I might answer?
No.
I'm not sure if I'll answer. He said, call on me.
Yeah.
And I will answer.
Yeah,
that's all we've done for 3 days is call on him. And he's going to answer today. He's already answered. But today is he. I think what Brother Tunnel's done tonight, for the rest of your life, you'll tell people. My life was changed in that service. It was there I decided to go to this country. It was there I decided to be a minister. I believe tonight's going to be life changing. He said, call on me, and I will answer, and I will show you great and mighty things that you don't know about. There are places in prayer you have never been. When I was 15 years old, I was in a youth camp. And a preacher stood up and asked us. He said, "How many of you young people have been in the presence of God so strong that from the back row to the front, people were falling on their faces because they could not stand in the presence of God? And for an hour, they could not pick themselves up. And nobody raised their hand." He said, "This is the greatest and the saddest thing in the world." He said, "Because I've seen it happen. I've seen the presence of God move that powerful. But you don't even know what I'm talking about. There were some places you've been in the presence of God. You felt God move. But there are still some things you've never seen. There are some places you've never been. And God wants to take you there.
Yes.
I'm talking about a revival where there are more people that pray through than there are in your church.
Yeah.
I'm talking about a revival where your city government officials show up at prayer meetings because they've heard of what happens in your church. People there is another level. I want to take just a moment on this thought. The power of more. And the danger of enough. Our world is consumed with more. Remember that word. We want more money.
Želimo više novca.
Prettier girl.
Lepšu devojku.
Better looking guy. Bigger muscles. Better looks.
Bolji izgled.
Better job.
Bolji posao.
More clothes. Faster car.
Brži auto.
Better job.
Bolji posao.
It doesn't matter what it is.
Nema veze šta je.
The flesh is never satisfied.
Telo nikad nije zadovoljno.
We always want more.
Uvek želimo više.
More of everything.
Više svega.
That's why we buy all the magazines. This will make you prettier. This will make you more popular. This will change your life. And we buy them and buy them and buy them. Some of you got more clothes than you'll ever be able to wear in your entire life. But we want more. It takes us over. But then, even though we want more than we could ever possibly need, when it comes to the things of the world, when it comes to the things of God, this is enough. We want all of the world we can get.
Želimo i sve što možemo da dobijemo.
I prayed 10 minutes.
Molim se 10 minuta.
It's enough.
Yeah.
I prayed at camp meeting.
Molim se na kampu.
It's enough.
Yeah. Dovoljno.
The richest man, John D. Rockefeller. Anybody know the name?
Yes.
Rockefeller.
At one time he was the richest man in the world.
On je bio najbogatiji čovjek na svijetu.
And when he was the richest man in the world,
i kad je bio najbogatiji,
somebody asked him, "How much more money do you need?"
Nekoga je pitao, koliko još novca trebaš?
How much is enough?
Koliko je dovoljno?
He said, "Just a little more."
Rekao, još samo malo.
The flesh is never satisfied.
Telo nikdy nie je zadovoljné.
Why don't we have the same attitude towards the Spirit?
Zašto nemáme stav ka stvarima ovog Svetog Duha?
Why don't we show up every service?
Zašto nismo na svakoj službi?
I want more than I've ever had before.
Right.
I want to feel your presence stronger than I've ever felt. I'm not satisfied.
Nisam zadovoljan.
Wanting more.
Želeti više.
Will change your life.
Promijeniti tvoj život.
I know people.
Znam ljude
who have lost their family,
koji su izgubili porodice,
lost their children,
decu,
because they wanted a job so much.
Jer su toliko želeli pot.
They wanted more money.
Više novca.
Yeah. They work weekends.
Radili su
they work days.
Radili su preko
nada. They work nights.
Radili su
noći. Because they wanted more.
Više.
And it completely changed their life.
I to je kompletno promijenilo.
Desire transforms you.
That's
right. Desire will change your life. And what you desire the most is what changes you the most.
That's right.
Anybody know anybody addicted to drugs?
Right.
Growing up, I knew a lot of people that were addicted.
Yeah.
Dok sam odrastao, poznao sam mnogo takvih.
Brother Tuttle, he pastored next to Amsterdam, grew up there. He can tell you about addictions.
On može da vam kaže o toj zavisnosti.
I remember when I was in high school, the first friend I ever had that overdosed, sitting next to me.
Yeah.
Sećam se kad sam došao u srednju školu, prvi prijatelj kojeg sam znao je umro od overdoze.
Blood dripping from his nose.
Krv je potekla iz njegovog.
And instead of wanting to go to the hospital,
umjesto da je želeo da ide u bolnicu.
He wanted to go back where he just got the drugs from.
Right.
Crazy.
Yeah.
But he was addicted.
Yeah.
I know a man that signed over the title to his car.
Znam čovjeka koji je napisao titulu na svom autu.
For one more hit.
Još samo jedna doza.
Yeah.
Because he was addicted.
Jer je bio zavisan.
Right.
You get addicted to the things of the world.
Možete da postanete zavisni na stvarima ovog sveta.
It'll destroy you.
To će vas uništiti.
But do you know you can get addicted to the things of God? Daniel said, I can't not pray. I gotta pray.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if there's a lion's
den.
It doesn't matter what anybody else says. I can't live without praying. I'm addicted to this. When you get addicted to the presence of God, and you want more of Him, it will change your life. Anybody know the story of Joshua and Caleb?
Da li neko zna priču o Joshua i Kalebu?
The Bible says Joshua and Caleb and 10 other spies.
Biblija kaže da su Joshua, Kaleb i još 10 spijuna.
They go and they look at the promised land.
Otišli da vide obećanu zemlju.
The land that God said, this is for you.
Zemlja za koju Bog rekao, ovo je za vas.
God said, you can have it.
Rekao, imaćete to.
And Caleb and Joshua said,
Kaleb i Joshua su rekli,
if you say we can have it,
ako ti kažeš da možemo,
we want it.
Right.
But the other 10 spies,
ali drugi 10 spijuna,
said, even though you said we can have it,
su rekli, iako si rekao da možemo da osvojimo,
we don't think we can have it.
Mi mislimo da ne možemo.
We don't want it.
Mi ne želimo.
We're fine with what we've got.
That's right. So this,
the Bible says that for Caleb was 40 years old.
Biblija kaže da je Kalef imao 40 godina.
For the, or 45 years old.
45.
For the next 40 years they were in the wilderness.
I sljedeće 4 godine su bili u pustinji.
Can you, Caleb is 55 years old.
Kalef ima 45 godina.
All his other friends besides Joshua are getting sick.
Svi njegovi prijatelji osim Joshua ili Sunamina postaju bolestivi.
But Caleb's fine.
Ali Kalef je u redu.
Hey, why don't you get sick?
Zašto se ti ne razboliš?
I don't know.
Jasno.
There's something's happening.
Nešto se dešava.
20 years go by.
Yeah. 20 godina prođe.
Caleb is 75 years old.
Kalef ima 75 godina.
His friends are dying.
Njegovi prijatelji umiru.
And Caleb's still strong.
Yeah.
He's not sick.
No.
10 more years go by. Caleb's 85 years old. His friends, besides Joshua, all of his friends have died. And Caleb's still okay. He goes up to them and he tells them.
On dođe i kaže.
He says, I was 40 years old.
Kaže, imao sam 40 godina.
When God brought me into this land. He said, and now after 40 years in the wilderness.
Nakon 40 godina u pustinji.
I'm as strong now as I was then.
Ja sam jak sada kao što sam bio tada.
I can fight the enemy now and win.
Mogu da se borim sa neprijateljem.
The same way I could then.
Isto kao i pre.
I haven't gotten any older.
Nisam ostario.
My body had something has changed in me.
Nešto se promijenilo u meni.
And I can see the people asking him.
I vidim ljude koji ga pitaju.
Caleb, what happened to you?
Caleb, šta se dogodilo tebi?
Why haven't you? What happened?
Šta se dogodilo?
Why haven't you been affected like everybody else?
Zašto ti nisi zahvaćen svima ovime kao svi ostali?
How are you getting stronger while the others are dying?
Kako su ti jak, a svi su tako slabi?
Why are you getting promises that nobody else is here to get?
Zašto ti imaš obećanje koje niko drugi ne dobije?
Caleb says, I can't explain it.
Rekao, ne mogu da objasnim.
The only thing I did differently.
Jedinu stvar koju sam radio drugačije.
Is when I looked at what God said I could have.
Rekao, kad na to što je Bog rekao, možemo.
I wasn't satisfied with enough.
Sam bio zadovoljen sa ovim.
I wanted more. I don't want to go back where I came from. I don't want to live my life knowing there's something else I could have done. There's a victory I could have had. He said, the only thing I did is I wanted to be more. I wasn't satisfied with where I was. You think he regretted that decision? Not a day in his life. Elisha.
Elisej.
He follows the man of God.
On prati muž, Božjeg čovjeka.
Who has an awesome ministry.
Koji ima sjajnu službu. Right.
And then when the man of God's gone.
I kada,
or the man of God asked Elisha one day.
Yeah. Kada muž Božji kaže Elisej jednog dana.
He says, what do you want?
Yeah. Šta želiš?
What's the first question we asked you? Where are you?
Šta je prvo pitanje koje smo rekli? Gde si?
Who are you?
Ko si ti?
The last question you have got to get in your mind.
Poslednje pitanje koje morate da zapamtite.
What do you want?
Želiš?
You want the church you've always been a part of?
Želiš crkvu?
The same small youth group?
Isto malo.
The same prayers?
Iste molitve.
Or do you want to see something you've never seen? Elisha looked at him. He said, I want double what you have. You want more? But I'm an awesome man. I've seen a lot of miracles. Can God do more? Well, yes. Then I want more.
On the shelling
I want more.
Da li neko video kako se mrtvi dižu iz mrtvih?
What?
Šta?
None of you have prayed for a dead person?
Niko od vas nije molio za mrtva.
And they came back to life?
Da su se vratili u život.
Anybody pray for deaf ears and they were open?
Da li se neko molio za gluve uši da su se otvorile?
You? What's wrong with the rest of you?
Šta nije u redu sa vama ostalima?
Anybody pray for blind eyes and they're open?
Da li se neko molio za zatvorene oči koje su se otvorile?
Are you trying to make us feel bad? Well, don't be messing with story. You can't be the only one.
Yeah.
You never get a chance.
Did Jesus do it?
Da li je to Isus radio?
Yeah.
Jesus did all these things.
Isus radio sve ove stvari.
And he turned to the people.
I vratio se ljudima.
And he said,
I rekao,
you'll never do the things that I've done.
Nikad nećete raditi stvari koje sam ja radio.
But you can pray for headaches.
Ali molite se za glavobolje.
And you can pray for hurt feelings.
Is that
what he said?
No.
He said, you think this is awesome?
Yes.
Greater things than this. Do you want it? It's yours if you want it. You can go home and turn your entire school upside down. You can go home and within years you can have a church that you have to buy more and more buildings because you don't have anywhere for them to sit. You can build a youth group all by yourself. You can see the dead raised. You can pray for cancer and watch them be completely healed.
No,
high school. Oh, you're right. God's power has everything to do with you.
Yeah.
No. What are we always asking? How come we don't see the same miracles we used to see? How come the sun never stands still anymore? How come there's no more Moseses that part the water?
Kako više nema Mojsija koji razdvaja vodu?
Why doesn't God do what he used to?
Zašto Bog ne radi to što je radio?
He said, I'm the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. God said, you want to see water part? Give me a Moses. You want to see the sun stand still? Give me a young man that's willing to ask me to do it. You want to see miracles like that we saw with Noah in the ark? Then give me a young man that's willing to look crazy to the rest of the world and do whatever I ask him to do. If you're going to fit in the next world, you're going to have to be okay not fitting in this world.
Right.
The Bible says we are the light. Let your light so shine that they may see you. If you blend in with the world, how in the world are they supposed to see him?
Yeah.
How could they be the
Negro? Gotta be different. That's right.
There's a reason we dress holy.
That's right.
There's a reason we live a certain way. Because we reflect him. But God knows my heart.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter what anybody else thinks of me.
Yes, it does.
Yeah, it does.
No,
it doesn't matter. God knows my heart.
Yeah.
God told Samuel,
yeah.
Man looketh on the outward appearance.
That's right.
Człowiek gleda na spoleczny izgled.
But God looks on the heart.
That's right.
God did not say, let your light so shine.
Bóg nie rekał, neka twoje światło świetli.
That he could see your good work.
Yeah.
He said, no, that they may see your good work. So if man looks at the outside appearance, and God wants them to see Jesus in me, then something on the outside of me has to match up what's inside of me.
That's
why he said, if any man say, I love the Father,
yeah.
But you don't love your brother, the love of the Father is not in you. It matters where you go.
Yes, it does.
It matters what you look at. It matters what you listen to. It matters the way you treat people.
Yeah. Yes, it does.
Oh, we're so far off of notes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You may be in different churches.
Možda ste u različitim crkvama.
The Bible doesn't say the families of God.
Ja ne kaže porodice Božje.
It says the family. It doesn't say the brides of Christ.
Ne kaže nevesta, nevesta Hristove.
The bride.
Nevesta Hristova.
Look around, this family.
Texas.
We have something called the Hatfield-McCoy feud. It was where the McCoy family, not me, great-grandfather, and the Hatfield family, they all begin to fight. Hundreds of family members. The fight got so bad, the army had to come in and separate
it.
All my life, my dad used to tell me, you'd better not get into a fight. But if somebody's picking on your brothers or sisters, and you don't do something about it, I'm going to whip you. You better not fight. But you don't let anybody pick on family. I didn't get into a lot of fights because of me. Some. Somebody tried to take my family. But if you call my sister a name, you pick on my baby brother, I have to. Or I get a whipping. We don't let anybody pick on family.
Right.
But some of us, we're so good at killing each other and tearing down each other, the devil doesn't even have to do anything. The devil doesn't have to fight us. We fight each other. Oh, she doesn't need to be praying like that. I can't believe he's got his hands lifted. I know what he put on Facebook. I know what she did last week. And we're just killing each other. It's family.
Right.
Hey, don't pick on my family.
Right.
Your friend, you got people that'll stay on the phone with you all night long to talk about your pastor and how he doesn't love you. And your friends aren't being nice to you. And your church is too judgmental. And it's not fair. They'll talk all night. But you call them and tell them about what God did for you. Okay, I got to go. You need new friends.
Yes, you do.
I don't need anybody hurting me.
That's right.
I need people to help me. Brother Tuttle said it so well last night. Hey, did you hear what Selway did? Did you hear what she did?
Ali brat Tatvi je rekao juče, da li ste čuli šta je uradio?
If it ain't good, I don't need to know.
That's right.
That's my sister.
Yeah.
That's my brother.
Amen.
Ako nije dobro, onda ne želim da čujem. To je moj brat, to je moja sestra.
We protect each other.
Štitite jedan drugog.
That's how we become what God created us to be.
Postajemo to što Bog želi da postanemo. Zašto nas je stvorio?
I don't even know how I got on that.
Ne znam kako se stiglo do toga.
He said, you want to see the miracles?
Neko želite da vidite čuda?
Be the vessel I can use.
Be the vessel.
Be the person that's willing to be an outcast. Be the person that doesn't leave the altar first. Be the person they have to carry back to the room. Because you're drunk in the Holy Ghost. Be the person that doesn't leave the altar. Be the first one up in the morning. Somewhere in a corner praying. And I'll show you the miracle. It's yours if you want it.
Tvoje ako želiš.
it will change you. But you have to want it more than anything. It's easy to talk about. But it costs everything. You have to forget about what everybody else thinks. You have to be okay looking crazy to people. And say, I want it more than anything. I remember when my grandfather, 90 years old, had Alzheimer's.
You know that?
Alzheimer's. Didn't know my name.
Memory loss.
Didn't know my name.
Nije znao moje ime.
Didn't know his own son's name.
Nije znao ime svog sina.
I'd go in there and sit with my grandfather.
Ja ulazim I sedim s njim.
And his head just tossing.
Njegova glava samo ide levo desno.
Didn't even know who I was.
Nije ni znao ko sam ja.
But you can start singing an old song.
Yeah.
Možete pevati staru pesmu.
Jesus. His hands. He started clapping his hands.
Yeah.
He started saying the word. He couldn't remember any. He couldn't remember his own family. But you start singing about Jesus. And there was something else. The doctors couldn't understand what Jesus was. It's something stronger than anything else in the world. It's a desire for more. It's a desire for more of His presence. My grandmother was in a coma. Couldn't even respond to us. We would hold hands around her. And we'd start praying. She starts speaking in another tongue. What is this? That when I can't even recognize my own family, when I can't even say a word, there's something about the presence of God that's so powerful that even when everything in my body should not be able to speak, the words start coming when the anointing flows. There's something stronger. More powerful than anything in your life. But you have to want it.
I didn't want it to do it.
In America, we had the Great Civil War. The north part of America went to war with the south part of America. Brother against brother. And while all the soldiers were away at war, the robbers would come to the farms. And they would steal all the valuables. Because the men were all gone. And so what the ladies would do is they would take all of their valuables. The gold, the silver, the candlesticks, the jewelry. And they would dig a hole about 3 meters in the ground. And they put it all in there. And then they fill it up with dirt. And then they would dig another hole. Maybe a half a meter. And they would put the little cheap stuff in it. The stuff that wasn't real valuable. And when the thieves would come, they would see where they buried it. And they would dig up the ground. They find the little cheap stuff. And they think, we found it. And then they leave thinking, we got everything they had.
Yeah.
Never knowing that if they'd have just dug a little bit deeper, there was more valuables than they ever could have imagined. And we come up to an altar. And we dig a little bit.
Yeah.
We pray just a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, I felt something.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
We can go.
Yeah.
We can go home from camp. I felt something.
Yeah.
Oh, that felt wonderful. And God's sitting there.
Oh,
don't stop digging.
Yeah.
Do you know what was a little bit too? walk out.
Mnogo puta odemo.
It's almost like God sitting there.
Skoro da Bog sedi, kao da Bog sedi tu.
That's all you wanted?
Kažem, to je sve što želiš?
You remember the blind eye being open?
Yeah.
The deaf ear? The lame walking? All that is at the same altar that you just left.
Yeah.
But it's deeper than where you're at. It's yours if you want it. I put it in there. But you have to dig. You've got to want it. It's yours if you want it. But it's up to you. And we leave. We come sick in our body. And we walk out. I feel better. But I'm not healed. We come in here with broken homes. And we leave. Things are a little better. But not how they should be. But we have learned to live with enough.
Yeah,
that's true.
Do you know what they used to do to the prisoners of war? In World War
II,
the same grandfather, he was a spy, is now the CIA. Incredible man. I have to tell you the story. There's books about him. He said when they would take them, when they would become a prisoner of war, when they would first get there, the other prisoners would tell them, if you want to escape, you have to go now. You have to go now. You've got to go tonight. I'll go later. He said, no, you can't. Because they barely feed us enough. Slowly, you'll lose strength. You'll lose muscle. You'll lose your will. They'll feed you enough to keep you alive. But not enough for you to fight. This is the strongest you'll ever be. You've got to go now. And the enemy wants you to learn to live with just enough.
Yeah.
Just enough to get by. And God's sitting there today saying, don't you know what I can do for you? Call on me. And I will answer. And I will show you great things. I'll show you something you've never seen. I'll show you things your family's never
dreamed
of. I'll take you to a place so far in my presence. You won't even want to come home. That's what he did with Enoch. The Bible said he walked with God. And then he was not. There's another level if you want it. Well, how do I get there? If this is it, how do I get it? One word. Desire. There was a young man. He was tired. In musician, you can give it. He was tired of going through the motions. He was tired of barely having enough. He said, I've got to have more. But I don't know how to get it. And so he started going through the village. Do you know how I can find more? Do you know where I can get more of God? Do you know where I can get more of God? One of them said, do you really want to find out? He said, yes. They said, if you go on top of the mountain, there's a very old wise man. He can help you find God like you want to. So he got all of his stuff. He started climbing up to the mountain. He found this little house at the top of the mountain. He knocked on the door. This old man opened the door and said, yes. He said, they tell me
Rekli su mi
that you can help me get more of God.
Ti možeš da mi pomogneš.
I want to know him like I've never known him. I want to see him.
Želim da ga vidim.
He said, you really want him more than anything?
The
young man said, yes. How?
Kako?
The man said, I'll help him. So the old man took him down the mountain. He took him to a river. He said, I want you to kneel down with me. So they knelt down and they looked into the edge of the river. While the young man is kneeling down by the water, the old man grabbed him by the back of his neck and shoved his hand right down
in
the
water.
The young man is underwater, waiting for a revelation. Nothing happens. 30 seconds go by. 40 seconds go by. Then something happens. He starts running out of breath. I don't see God. All of a sudden he needs air. He starts to pull his head up. That old man just pushes him down even further. And he's starting to get water inside of his lungs. He's fighting. He's kicking. He don't care about the old man anymore. He don't care about anything. All he wants is to get up. Finally, at the last moment, that old man lets his head up out of water. He says, what's wrong with you? Are you crazy? You're trying to kill me. The old man looked at him. He said, when you want to find God as much as you wanted the next breath, you'll find it. Yes. More than anything this world has to offer. When you want him more than the habit you can't seem to lay down. When you want him more than the sin that doesn't seem to want to let go of you. More than sin. When you want him more than to be popular. When his opinion of you is more important than their opinion. You'll find him. You were made for more than this. It's yours if you want it. If you want it more than anything in your life, it will change you like you can't.